नमस्कार, हूँ आदर्श। वेलकम टू आदर्श एजुकेशन सोसाइटी। स्टैंडर्ड 9th, सब्जेक्ट साइंस, चैप्टर 1, मैटर इन अवर सराउंडिंग्स। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे विल डिस्कस द गैसियस स्टेट। हैव यू एवर ऑब्जर्व्ड ए बलून सेलर filling a large number of balloons from a single cylinder of a gas? So students, have you seen the balloon sailor? He is filling large number, lot of balloons from a single cylinder, small cylinder. Enquire him, how many balloons is he able to fill from one cylinder? Ask him how many balloons can he fill up within the small cylinder, maybe of 50 balloons. Ask him which gas does he have in the cylinder, and also get the message from him what gases, helium gas, because it is the lightest gas. Get the answer from him. Now the next one, take three 100 ml syringes. Take 300 ml syringes. What is syringe? Syringe is a device used for injecting, and close their nozzles by the rubber cocks. See, look here now. See this one, look the diagram. This one is the syringe. Here, the rubber cork, nozzles, you look here now, larger nozzles. See this one, this neck, here rubber cork. Okay, and this is a piston. What is piston? Solid disc that fits inside a hollow cylinder. This is the piston. It fits inside a hollow cylinder. Now here what is asked, so you look here now, by the rubber cork as shown in the figure, remove the pistons from all the syringes. Remove the pistons, this you have to remove it from all this, leaving the one syringe untouched. So now you know that now you have taken three syringes, in one syringes not to touch, fill the water in the second. So another, what, second cylinder you are putting the water, in third cylinder you are putting the pieces of chalk. So understand students, in one cylinder, second cylinder water, it means liquid you are filling, in third cylinder you are chalk, means a solid you are filling, the leaving the one syringe untouched, first syringe you are untouched, it means it filling with gas. So gaseous, liquid and solid you are experiencing. Now what you have to do, insert the pistons back into the syringes. So you have to apply force. You have to apply the force to the pistons. Now observe that, see, I have to apply the force like this. Force you have to apply. What may be the result you are getting? You have to apply the force. So you have to put pressure on this like this. Insert the pistons back into the syringes. You may apply some Vaseline also. Vaseline, a petroleum jelly. It acts as a lubricant before inserting them on the syringes for their smooth movement. Now try to compress. See, look, the compress the contained, pushing downwards, pushing the piston in each syringes. So you have to observe it. Okay, you know that the first syringes gaseous is there, the second syringes liquid water is there, and third syringes solid chalk piece is there. So what is your observation? The asking the question, look here now, the question is here, what do you observe? In which case was the piston easily pushed in? So what is the observation of yours? In which case the piston is, see, you know that students, In the first syringe, there is air. Okay. The piston in this case is pushed easily. The piston in this case is pushed easily in the syringe. Why? Because gases can be compressed very easily. Very easily. The piston is pushed with the great difficulty in the remaining two syringes. Means in the liquid and solid, you have get little difficulty. You have to apply a little bit force as compared to the gases. Gases can be easily compressed. Okay, from this you will get the information like this. Now we have to observe that gases are highly compressible. So question arises, which is the highly compressible? Which state? Gases is can be are highly compressible as compared to the solids and liquids. Okay, because you know that this, because of arrangement of the molecules in the gases, is very very far. So gases can be compressed. Compressed means to make smaller, or to come, or to squeeze it, to press together. The liquefied petroleum gas. So here the question arises, what do you mean by liquefied petroleum gas? Or write the full form of liquefied petroleum gas. Liquefied, LIQUEFIED, liquefied petroleum gas, LPG. Have you observed that the liquefied petroleum gas cylinder that we get in our home for cooking, this is a compressor gas only. The oxygen supplied to the hospitals in the cylinders, it is also a compressor gas. See, oxygen supplied to the hospitals. So these are all compressor gas. This, okay, see, okay, this can be, these are all using at home and hospitals. Compressed, another one. Now, compressed natural gas, see another. Compressed natural gas, CNG. What is the full form of CNG? Compressed natural gas. COMPRESSED, compressed CNG. Sometimes asking in the examination, write the full form of CNG. Is used as a fuel these days in the vehicles. Due to the high compressibility, large volume of the gas can be compressed into a small cylinder and transported easily. So you know that due to the compressibility, you know that gaseous arrangement of the molecules are very very far, so that you can bring into the smaller by applying the pressure into the small. Such a large volumes of the gas can be compressed into a small cylinder and transported easily. So you come to know that what is being, so now next we come to know that what is being cooked in the kitchen without even entering there, without you are going there, you are getting by the smell that reaches our nostrils. So you are not going in the kitchen room, but even you are outside also, you will get the smell. How does this smell reach us? You know that the particles of the aroma, smell, fragrance of the food mix with the particles of the air. The particles of air spread from the kitchen reach us even farther away. So you know that the molecules of the gas moves faster. The gaseous molecules moves faster. The smell of the hot cooked food reaches within seconds. Compare this with the rate of the diffusion of the solids and liquids. So you have to compare it, the rate of the diffusion, intermingling of the gases, rate of the diffusion, intermingling of the particles of the solids, liquids and gaseous comparison, which will be the more you have learned. Now you have observed gaseous can diffuse very easily, very fast due to the high speed. Why? Because due to the high speed of the particles and large space between them. So you know that in the gaseous, high speed of the particles and large space between them, gases shows the property of diffusing very fast into the other gases. So gaseous shows very fast, can diffuse very fast into other gases. In the gaseous state, the particles move about randomly. See the word random. Randomly means without any direction. It moves in any way at high speed, without any particular direction, at high speed. Due to this random movement, so you know that when you are running without any direction, if you are running, what will happen? You may dash with someone, correct? So due to the random movement, the particles hit each other, hit means dash each other, and also walls of the container. The pressure exerted by the gases, because of this force, the pressure exerted by the gas. So you have pressure created by the gas. This force exerted by the gas particles per unit area on the walls of the container. Look the here. See this one. See here solid. See the arrangement of the molecules in the solid. Molecules are in the fixed position and have a maximum intermolecular force. Intermolecular force here, look here now. Have a, these are all fixed. And intermolecular force is lead here, the intermolecular force applying the least here. See, they have a fixed position. And when you are look here, the arrangement of the molecules, molecules can move easily because the spaces between them. Here intermolecular force is little what you are saying? Medium. And here look the gaseous. Gaseous look, and the arrangement of the molecules is so far. So gaseous molecules can freely move. Intermolecular force is very least is here. Okay, so this gaseous, see, look the balloon. The gas molecules can easily move, and here given per unit area, the force exerted by the per unit area on the walls of the containers. So there may be the breaks of the balloons. So balloon met, burst, correct? So look here. Now we move on to, can matter change its state? Can matter change its state? We know that the observation that water can exist in three states of matter. So water can exist in three states. As a solid, state ice, as a liquid, water, gas, water vapor. You know that water is made up of particles. See, water is made up of particles, correct? When the what, these three states of water, water is made up of particles, as a solid, as a liquid, and as a gaseous, what happens inside the matter during the change of state? See, in the water, see like these particles, in between the gaps, see look here, the states of the particles. What happens inside the matter during the change of the state? During the change of the state, water is made up of particles during the change of the state. Okay, so as a solid, what happens? As a gaseous, what happens? What happens to the particles of matter? This what happens? When all these three states are made up of this water. So during the change of the states, how does this change of the state takes place? How does this change of the particle state takes place? You know that we need answer to these questions. Even what you have to give the answer of this. Okay, so we'll go for some more explanation how it happens, how can be changed. So effect of change of the temperature, effect of change of temperature. Effect of change of temperature. Take about 150 grams of ice in a beaker. So what you have to do? take 150 grams and suspend a laboratory thermometer so that its bulb is in contact with the ice. See, look the diagram. Here, take a ice beaker. This one is laboratory thermometer, suspended, means hang freely. This one is beaker. This one is stirring, glass stirrer, stirring for mixing. This one is burner. And here also see thermometer, glass stirrer, beaker, water, this burner. And here you are first, what you are observing, here ice, and here you are observing water. Look, there is conversion of ice into water. First diagram, conversion of ice into water. And second one is conversion of water into water vapor. For the conversion, you are applying the temperature. See, conversion, temperature you are applying. Take about 150 grams of ice in a beaker and suspend a laboratory thermometer so that its bulb is in contact with the ice. So, ice, contact with the ice. Now, what is your observation? Start heating the beaker on a low flame. Note the temperature when the ice starts melting. Note the temperature when all the ice has started to beaker. Here, understanding question is there. See, what is there? Note the temperature when the ice starts. When the ice starts melting, see, you know that ice piece starts melting. This one starts melting. Then, when all the ice, complete full of ice, see, this full of ice starts melting. First, it starts melting in the particular place. Then whole ice starts melting when all the ice has converted to water. Record your observation. Record your observation for this conversion of solid into liquid state. See, what the observation? So, the observation, the ice starts melting at 0 degrees Celsius. All the ice get converted into water also at 0 degrees Celsius. Correct? During the change of the ice into water, the temperature remains constant at 0 degrees Celsius. See, during the change of the ice into water, the temperature remains constant at 0 degrees Celsius. Record your observations. Thank you for joining us.